So what's up everyone? So in this video I'm going to show you how to draw and how to construct it. So it's a good word to say how to construct a use case diagram in Staruml. So it's used in software design. So I hope you have this in your syllabus. So let's get started. So first just open Staruml. So those who don't know what Staruml is basically a software used to develop this kind of diagram, the activity diagram, use case diagram, class diagram, this list of diagrams I would say. So this many diagrams for software design, what you have, so that can be done by using Staruml. It's absolutely free. I've also done a video how to download Staruml, so it's there. So check it out if you haven't downloaded it. Now let's go into it. So first open Staruml and just go to model, add diagram, and you have the use case diagram. So just click it. So as you can see here, all the shapes that are necessary to draw a use case diagram is inbuilt ready for us. So for use case diagram, basically we need the actors. So first, for that I'm going to consider first topic. So my topic that I'm going to design as use case diagram is going to be a library, online library management system. So it's going to be a very simple one. It's going to have a member or the user and the librarian who is going to maintain it. So this is going to be done in an automated or an online way. So first you need the actors. So first I will let me put a text, okay. So it's going to be library. So it's not library, it's going to be online library management system. Okay. So that's good. So you can change the size, bold text, format, everything is there. It's fine with this. And next thing is we will come to the use case diagram. So first thing is the actor. So I will just take this actor and drag and drop it here. Oops, going there. Okay, so let me place it here. So our library management system, the actor is going to be the user, or I would say library member. Just like it. So it's going to be member. Okay, this is going to be our first actor, and another actor in this is our librarian. This is the owner of a library, whoever it is. So it's going to be librarian. Okay. So now we are just going to use that use case. Okay, this refers to the use case, so it's a form of an ellipse or however you can say it. Okay, so you just can do it like this. Just place it in the center between both the actors. So our first use case is going to be, so we are just constructing an online system. So first, whatever may be the need, business or like that, etc., what you're going to do, the basic thing that how will you start using an automated system online is to log in, register. So these are the basic factors. So I would recommend you do log in, register for whatever may be the online or automated system. So first we will start with register. Register, okay, and nicely move it. Okay, push it up. I think we can't copy. Okay, we can't copy. Can we paste it? Okay, so we can even copy and paste it. So that's very good. And second thing is going to be login. So after register, you're going to log in. So login. Oh, both are changing. Okay. So Control X. So don't do that. I thought it will. Just drag and drop. Okay. Next thing is going to be login, and our next thing is going to be checking status. Okay, so this may vary depending upon your model that you're going to design. So for basically library, we need to check the status of the book. Okay, whether it's overdue, whether you have paid the amount, whether is there any fine, or is your date over, or do you need to renew the date of usage. So like that, there are many things on there. So check status is also important thing in library management system. So I will put check status. You can do anything, whatever you want according to your topic. So I'm just going to give a hint, another 2-3 topics only I'm going to do. So return, next thing is going to be user verification issue book. So okay, so there can be two ways the library operates. There can be even ebooks that the library, particular library, can give access to the users. So I'm considering that ebooks over here. So That's what this is going to represent. And next thing is the notifications. This is enough, I think so. Okay, this is enough for demo purpose thing. Okay, there are also many things that you can do, like due date, return book, logout, notifications, issue book, user verification. Like this, there are many things that can be done by using this. User verification is, I think it's also a common thing to all the automated online systems. So you can include that in your own. And notifications. Okay, that's good. So that's it. Now only thing we'll do is just to give this arrows. Just give it like this. No need of naming anything. If you move the arrow, will also move. Just so login checking status is for the user. Okay, no connection. Okay, and these two is going to be done by the librarian. Issuing books and notifications can be sent by the librarian to the. So that's it. So that's a simple. You can also even draw an arrow. I think you can't draw an arrow like that. Remember, so there's a simple use case diagram. I have also done activity diagram in another video, so check out that also. And mine is a program channel. I have done many tutorials in program stuff like C, C++, Java, Unity, Blender, 3D animation, game development. So please check, subscribe and support my channel. And thanks for watching.